Apple Valley's Brindley Brown continues to dazzle on The Voice and passing remarks for Golden State schools. Your High Desert Metro News starts now. Good evening, Terry Kurtz here. Thank you for joining us on this edition of your High Desert Metro News. California schools bring home a good report card.
A solid majority of Californians favor providing parents with tax-funded vouchers to send their children to any school they choose, while at the same time, most surveyed give their local public schools good grades. These are among the key findings of a statewide survey on education released by the Public Policy Institute of California. Two schools in the Apple Valley Unified School District have been selected for 2016 California Honor Roll recognition. Apple Valley High School and Rio Vista School of Applied Learning, both chosen by the Educational Results Partnership and the Campaign for Business and Education Excellence as two of the public schools in the state to receive the honor roll status. What are some factors setting Rio Vista apart?
One of the most unique aspects are our students. They are just fabulous kids. And then the parent involvement. You will never come on this campus when there's not parents here highly involved in their children's education. They're working in the classrooms, in our workroom. You'll see them on the playgrounds. They are just highly involved.
The honor roll is part of a national effort to recognize schools which demonstrate consistent high levels of student academic achievement, as well as improvement in reducing achievement gaps among student populations. For high schools, the honor roll also includes measures of college readiness. Honor roll schools are either named scholar schools or, like Apple Valley High School and Rio Vista, star schools. Star schools are those with significant populations of socioeconomically disadvantaged students that have shown a significant increase in grade-level proficiency over time. These are students from schools in the Apple Valley District presenting science fair exhibits in the district-wide competition.
Today we have 89, and fortunately we have another one coming, so we'll be right at 90 exhibits today.
Science projects today are not of your grandparents' variety.
Our project involves implicit biases and the role that they play in our society. Racism is such a huge problem in our society, and it's very, very controversial, especially now. We asked students in our high school randomly, we took random surveys, and we asked them if they would consider themselves to be racist. And the vast majority, like 95% of them, said, no, I would not consider myself a racist. And We asked them another question: have they witnessed racial biases or discrimination in school? And 84% of them said they had. So we were just kind of thinking, well, what's the disconnection there? Why do people identify as not being racist, but they see racial discrimination? And we showed the control group two pictures of two young Caucasian boys holding toy guns. And we showed the experimental group two young African-American boys holding two toy guns. And we asked them if they saw anything wrong in the picture, if they would let their child hang out with them, if they would want their child around the kid in the picture.
We did find that there was significant and recordable biases that we recorded. So as long as these implicit biases are part of us, we are going to have issues with racism.
Now, there'll be 18 projects selected this evening who get to move on to the county fair.
Speaking of moving on, Apple Valley High School student, now national singing sensation and The Voice contestant, Brindley Brown, continues moving on and up in the finals rounds of performances on the NBC Talent Contest. Brindley Brown was again extraordinary in singing Linda Ronstadt's Long, Long Time on NBC Television's live performance phase of the competition. The 15-year-old continues displaying a combination of poise and intuition, technique and dynamics far beyond her years. Brindley explained her choice of Long, Long Time by saying she hopes to include a cover of the Ronstadt classic on her first CD Interestingly enough, Long, Long Time was a hit for Linda Ronstadt very early in her career, her first solo release, actually, after Different Drum with the Stone Ponies. The powerful ballad is considered one of the very difficult songs to cover and do it justice. Brinley Brown's coach, Gwen Stefani, described her performance as perfect, after giving the singing cowgirl a standing ovation. Brinley was voted to advance into the final 10 by voters from across America. She will perform next week.
Wow, Brinley Brown is definitely making a name and a song for herself on The Voice. What a terrific story to follow. Straight ahead, Charlie Ray adds some drama to our newscast. Can vigilantes in a Barstow grocery store overpower a violent thief? Please stay with us.